Known as a snail fish, this is the deepest living kind of fish yet discovered. And here are two new species filmed for the very first time. The snail fish are not here for the bait itself, but to pick off any scavengers the bait attracts. In mission control, it's been 2 hours since they last made contact with the sub.
Yeah, attention all stations. Yeah, be advised, we can hear Victor, but we cannot communicate with him. He cannot hear us. He's very close to the lander.
Yeah, I'd say within a couple of hundred meters, so he must be near the bottom.
Insulation fault. That's probably just some water residue in there. Everything's looking good.
I should be getting there really close now.
Oh my.
And I can see something on the bottom. Now I'm seeing the bottom much more clearly. I've just reached the bottom of the Southern Ocean. Looks like a moonscape out of one of my portals.
Surface, LF, at bottom, repeat.
On the bottom.
Yeah.
I am at bottom. I'm at the bottom of the Southern Ocean.
Victor is an amazing 24,388 feet below the surface, where no human has ever been before. The team have also deployed here their three remaining science probes, or landers, baited with tempting fish carcasses. And although Victor's external sub cameras may have cut out, amazingly, the cameras on the landers are still working. They now capture Victor's arrival at the bottom, his lights just visible across the sea floor. These are the first ever images captured at the bottom of the South Sandwich Trench. And attracted by the lander's bait, there's already a crowd of super strained specialists able to endure intense cold and enormous pressure.
See, tiny, white, they're like perfectly white. They look like tadpoles.
What's that over there?
Larger creature, a little pink on the top. He has a little pink head, two big eyes. Oh, he's definitely swimming. He's swimming away from my blast.
It seems that Victor has identified a mysid, a type of crustacean whose bright red color in fact makes it even more invisible in the pitch dark of the deep ocean. 1,500 feet further up the trench slope, a second lander is capturing remarkable images of the range of life that thrives here. Sea lilies and tall tubular glass sponges. Both snag passing microorganisms drifting past in the current. And higher up the slope still, a third lander is capturing the first ever footage in this trench of a truly remarkable creature. Known as a snail fish, this is the deepest living kind of fish yet discovered. And here are two new species filmed for the very first time. The snail fish are not here for the bait itself, but to pick off any scavengers the bait attracts. Finally, the lander's auto-release mechanisms activate, and they head back to the surface. But now comes the massive challenge of safely retrieving these $200,000 pieces of equipment in heavy seas.
What do we got?
I think I'll just be happy if it lands on deck. Oh.
It's the most difficult site to catch on because of the arm.
Having lost two landers already, the pressure is on.
Charlie, we're going to have to cross the tag lines.
Yeah. Oh, no, no, no. Oh. Don't lose your balance.
Oh, it's like a something.
Whoa. Right, got it. Wait, 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 wait.
All right, got it.
That's good.
All right, what does the bait look like?
Oh, there we go.
There's absolutely thousands of us.
The team have a vital hoard of specimens from 24,000 feet down, whose chemical secrets could set the stage for scientific breakthroughs in the future.
hopefully we'll discover new molecules that have to do with combination of pressure and ultra cold temperatures. Those may have all kinds of applications. In China, they've been able to use the osmolite that we discovered in deep sea animals to actually cure glaucoma, which is a high pressure disease of the human eye.
Sensors on the landers have also brought back vital information that could confirm the route of the lifeblood current carrying nutrients from the Southern Ocean to the rest of the world. The data is dispatched to the British Antarctic Survey in the UK, where a team have been tracking the current at shallower depths.
The data we've been very kindly given confirm that this is Antarctic bottom water in there, that it is going through this trench. The actual flow through it is tens of times the flow of the Amazon, millions of tons a second.
It's a breakthrough that will be vital for future scientific work.
We can measure the water's flowing through to see any change, see any signals that are happening before it spreads out across the whole of the world's ocean floor. These very deep data are going to be very valuable for a long time.
Okay, I think that's a wrap. Surfacing weight release. And we're heading up.
Two and a half hours after leaving the bottom, Victor is now approaching the surface. But after his radio and cameras cut out in the cold, he has no way of knowing if there's an iceberg in his path. If there is, the sub could be pinned beneath the ice with no way out.
Just gonna come up slow. Hope I don't hit an iceberg. I hear a thump, I'm stopping quick. Going up, just be patient, Victor. 100 meters to go.
LF, comm check on VHF, how do you read?
Yeah, do you have visual?
Yeah, go ahead.
Welcome back, Victor.
Thank you, gentlemen. It's good to be back.
Zeno is inbound. Should be there any minute.
Roger that. Zeno inbound.
We had some comm issues, but we're going to talk about that after.
We're just glad to have you back on the surface and just rigging for recovery.
Roger that. Comms were a problem, but mission was a success.
Indeed it was. Indeed it was, sir. Great job.
Thank you, sir.
Just nice and slow. Nice and slow.
The sub may be safely back on the surface, but there's a final challenge to overcome in the volatile waters of the Southern Ocean.
Ride that thing, Steve. Good.
Oh, that was a big wave, guys.
The LF does not like being on the surface. It's designed to just dive. Get to the bottom, get there quickly. And she's like a wild horse, like you try to put a rope on it and it just fights you, right?
Up on the main. Get it, Steve.
Get down on the main.
Come on, Steve, get, go. Go.
All right, Steve.
Two hands, man. Up on the main, up on the main. That's good, Patrick. Good job, buddy. Yep. How you doing, Steve? You want to get off there? I can jump in there and do this. Steve, let's get you off. No, he's too cold. Hang in there, buddy. Steve, let's get you off.
To prevent the onset of hypothermia, the expedition doctor must bring Steve's body temperature back up. He sat him down next to the heating duct in the sub's hangar.
This is helping a lot.
Finally, Steve's warm enough to be moved inside.
So I'm dry on the inside. Doesn't this feel
good? Yeah, they're the right color.
Keep using those. Keep working.
Thank you. I've lived on the Tropic of Capricorn my whole life. That's close to the equator. I don't do cold water.
Last, Victor is safely back on board. He's now the only person to have reached the deepest point of the Southern Ocean, the second of his five deeps.
Good to be back.
Good to have you back.
Some interesting moments feeling quite alone in the middle of the Southern Ocean, but we got it done. It's good to be back. All right, it's kind of cold.
This is a very high-tech machine that we took to a very inhospitable place, and it was extraordinary. We're doing it because we're explorers, because we want to see. We want to push the boundaries. We want to learn things that haven't been learned before, and we want to do it together and bring it back and share it with other people.